Hey guys. Nice to see you. Let's start directly with our topic. Today we would like to talk to you about pointers and references. We already used pointers in our last video when we introduced you to the enable dynamic creation attribute and worked with the new and delete operators.
Now we will take a closer look at the pointers and also at the references. Both are quite similar at first glance and have different advantages and disadvantages when using them. A big advantage they both have is that they usually don't take up as much memory as the objects they are pointing to. It's often faster and more efficient to copy them than to copy the original object.
Let's start with the pointers.
Here we have a pointer in its natural environment. When we decide to use a pointer variable, this variable needs an identifier.
I think he looks like a pea baba.
Yeah, that is a good name for it. As you can guess, a pointer likes to point at other objects. This can be function blocks, instances, or variables. We want the pointer to point at this integer variable. To let the pointer know that he should point at an integer variable, we have to declare the pointer with a pointer to int. Now the pointer knows that he should point at an integer. The pointer knows that it should point to a variable of type integer, but doesn't check it. Means he also would point at a string variable, if we assign it to the pointer. It simply relies on us assigning it the correct object. And that can end in a great catastrophe. A misaddressed pointer can spread chaos and overwrite things it shouldn't overwrite, so watch out for this clumsy fellow. Because a pointer is really powerful.
We will use pbaba in TwinCAT. First, we declare a variable of the data type int. Now we declare our pointer. We write pointer to and then a data type. Now we can assign an address to the pointer with the address operator. Either in the declaration part, by assigning them as follows, colon equals ADR, open bracket, and now the variable from which the address is to be saved, closed bracket. Or we do it in the implementation part, baba colon equals ADR open bracket, variable whose address we want to save, closed bracket. The address of the variable is always the address of the first memory location, of the entire area that this variable occupies and is assigned by the system when the program is started. This address is now the value of the pointer. The pointer itself also has its own memory address. If we point with a pointer at the pointer, we will see that the addresses of the variable the pointer points to and the address of the pointer are not the same. Important to know, if a pointer to a localized input variable is used, the access is considered a write access. This leads to the compiler warning pointer name is not a valid assignment target during code generation. If you need a construct of this type, you must first copy the input value to a variable with write access. If we now look at the pointer, we see the address of the object to which the pointer is pointing. We can also see that the address of the pointer and the variable it is pointing to are different. If we click on the plus in front of the pointer variable, the name of the pointer appears again, but with the content operator. The content operator is the little roof you see there. And next to it, we see the value of the variable, pointed to by the pointer. With the content operator, we can dereference the pointer. That means we get the actual value of the variable pointed to by the pointer. If we change the value in here, the value of the variable the pointer is pointing to also changes. Using the content operator behind the pointer variable, we can easily change the value of the variable the pointer is pointing to. From TwinCAT 3.1 build 4026, you can use the command go to reference in online mode to jump from a pointer to the declaration location of the variable pointed to by the pointer. In 64-bit systems, the pointer always occupies 8 bytes of memory. It makes no difference whether the pointer points to a huge structure or to a one-byte variable.
When we observed the pointer, you could already watch him, pointing at a string variable he was not supposed to point at because he was declared as a pointer to int. We will demonstrate this scenario in TwinCAT. PBaba is declared as pointer to int and we assigned him to the address of the stringo variable. He has no problems with doing that. No warnings, nothing. We dereference the pointer and changed the value. As you can see, the value of our stringo variable was changing as well. We did this on purpose, but if this happens by accident, you could overwrite important data without noticing it. Keep in mind how powerful a pointer is. TwinCAT allows index access to pointer variables. The data which the pointer points to can be accessed by using the bracket operator behind the pointer identifier. For example, pbaba b open square bracket 2 closed square bracket. The data type and size of the indexed component is determined by the basic data type of the pointer. We want to give you an useful example. We declare an array with the index 0 to 5, of the type int. We assign some values to the elements. Now we create a pointer variable and call it pbaba start. It's a pointer with the base type int. And it points at our array. Another pointer variable, also of the type integer. This pointer will give us the address of the current element the other pointer is pointing to via index access. And we also create two integer variables. One is called baba value, this will display the value of our array element, and the other one is called I. The I variable is the index we will use for the pointer variable. At last we create a variable of the type bool. This variable will be used to trigger the if instruction we are going to write. The if instruction is used to move the pointer via the index from one array element to the next. We write if baba move then. Now we use our pointer variable pbaba address and write colon equals use the address operator and in brackets pbaba start behind it in the square brackets we use the index variable I. This line will give us the address of the accessed element. If you don't need the address, you can comment the line out. In the next line we write baba value, colon equals, and now you can either write pbaba start, in square bracket again the I variable, or you use the pbaba address and dereference it with the content operator. This is only possible if you use the pointer to get the address in the second line. In the next line it's the turn of variable I, we write I colon equals I plus 1. And another if instruction for I. If I equals 6 then, 6 because it is the number of our array elements. I equals 0. And 2 times end if. At the end. Baba move equals false, for every cycle that is done. Let's activate the configuration and log in. We start the program and change the value of baba move to true. It works, we can move the pointer with the index from element to element. Also good to know. You can subtract pointers. If you do so, the value of the difference between two pointers is of the type dword. The result shows how big the memory between the two addresses is.
Next, we would also like to introduce you to the fcheck memory area function and the etc memory area type. Both are included in the PLC library TC2 system. The etc memory area type is needed as a return value for the fcheck memory area function. As the name of the function already reveals, it tells you in which memory area the requested variable with the specified size is located. This can be really helpful when working with pointers. etc memory area is an enumeration and contains four members. Unknown, initialized with 0. You get this return value if the memory area is unknown. This happens, for example, with memory in the Windows context. You also get unknown back if the specified memory size results in two different memory areas being involved or if it is a stack memory. Unfortunately, one cannot differentiate between these possible cases, since they all have the return value unknown. Static is initialized with 1 and displayed if it is a static PLC memory. Dynamic is initialized with 2 and returned if the memory area is dynamically allocated memory. And CNC is initialized with 3 and displayed as return value if it is a CNC driver's memory. The fcheck memory area function contains two input variables: pdata of data type pvoid and nsize with type udent. Pdata gets the memory address of the variable and nsize gets the size of it. Now let's see how you can use the function in TwinCAT. Here you can see our example from our structure video, in which we created a structure dynamically. The type is called strustru. P strustru points at this type. We now add a variable of the type etc memory area to the declaration part. In the implementation part we write stru mem area equals fcheck memory area, in brackets, pdata equals pstrustru, nsize equals size of strustru. Pdata gets our pointer variable pstrustru as an input value and we assign the size of the type strustru to nsize with the size of operator. Let's see if it worked. The return value changes from unknown to dynamic when we start the program. And here is a simple example with a variable that is located in a statically memory area. We explained in a previous video the pvoid is a data type that is converted to a platform-compliant data type, depending on the target system. And as you see in the fcheck memory area function, a pvoid is quite useful because it allows the flexible use of the function. The pointer has no specified base type. That's why you can point to any object a pointer can point at. Let us talk about references now. Here we see one. It hangs around in the same environment as the pointer. They have a lot in common. But you will notice quickly that a reference is a lot more conscientious than a pointer. References also point to objects. A reference does this pointing implicitly, and in contrast to a pointer, a reference is implicitly dereferenced during the access. Means no special content operator is needed. For using references, we need an identifier. After this, we write reference to and then a data type. This data type is the base type of the reference. You can now use the reference as an alias for every variable with this data type. With a separate assignment operation, you can set the address of the reference by using the assignment operator ref equals. We choose the base type int for our reference, and now we initialize it with a string variable. In contrast to the pointer, the reference will not point to the variable because it is not an integer variable. A reference is type safe. In contrast to the pointer, it always checks if the object has the same type as its own base type before pointing at it.
Let's open TwinCAT. In here we have a variable of the type int. And now we declare the reference variable. Its identifier is called referi, and after the colon we write reference to int. We set the address of the reference with a separate assignment operation by using the assignment operator ref equals. We write referi. ref equals baba a. An exception of this is when an input is a reference to and the input is transferred within the function. In this case, the normal assignment operator is used instead of ref equals. Let's log in and start the program. As you can see, the reference takes the value from baba directly. We don't have to use the content operator to dereference the reference. It has accessed the contents of the referenced object directly. Now we try to assign our string variable to the reference. It doesn't work. We get an error, because the base type of the reference and the data type of the variable are different.
A reference always needs to be initialized with a variable of its base type. In contrast to a pointer, a reference can never refer to null. And it can't be created if it is uninitialized. TwinCAT initializes references with zero. As we mentioned before, the check pointer function also works for references. In addition, there is the isValidRef operator. This operator can be used to check whether a reference points to a valid value, for example, a value not equal to zero. In the declaration part, we declare two variables of the type bool and initialize them with false. One is called valref1 and the other valref2. For our example, we also declare another variable, referi2, as in reference to int. In the implementation part, we first write referi2, ref, equals, 0. Next, we use the operator. We write valref1 equals is valid ref. And in bracket, the identifier of the variable we want to check, referi. We do the same with the valref2 and check referi2 with the isValidRef operator. We log in and start the program. Valref1 turns into true, but valref2 stays false. This is because referi2 does not point to a valid value.
A reference type may not be used as the base type of an array, pointer, or a reference. In addition, a reference may not point to a bit variable. Such constructs generate compiler errors. In contrast, a pointer can be used, for example, as base type of an array, or a pointer. An advantage of references is that they are type safe. But as always, it depends on what you have in mind. Because it also can be good that the pointer is not type related. Both have advantages and disadvantages, and you should decide for yourself in which case a reference and in which case a pointer makes more sense. Keep in mind that a pointer is a more powerful tool than a reference. And that you could mess up things easily if you don't take care of your pointers. That's it for today.
Enjoy your time until the next video. Support us by liking and sharing our content. If you don't want to miss new videos, subscribe to our channel. Bye.
Bye-bye.